Hello friends, how's it going? It's me, Betty Jean. Today we are doing yet another ranking my last 10 palettes video. I love doing these videos. You guys seem to always enjoy them as well. I initially got this video idea from my friend Annette from Annette's Makeup Corner. I'll of course have her channel linked down below. These are just such a fun way for me to recap on the palettes that I used recently and kind of decide what I prefer over other things. Sometimes I surprise myself in these rankings and I think it's really interesting to reflect on. I have already done a halfway through the year ranking my 2021 palettes, and I will be doing a full 2021 palette at the end of the year as well. And as always, I inevitably get someone that says, wait, what about this palette that you used many months ago? Why is that not in the ranking? It's because it was in a previous ranking. I promise you, I always take notes on when I receive things, so I keep a list, and then once I hit 10, that's when I do these videos. So if you think I'm skipping something, it was probably in the last one. And of course, before we hop into it, I did of course film this look. It should already be up on my Instagram and TikTok by the time this video goes up. And let me just give you my jewelry and wig details and stuff like that. My plugs today, these cute little spiderweb plugs, I can't even show them to you. They're from Hear No Evil Jewelry on Etsy. I don't know where this choker's from. I just found it on a random website. It literally might have been Amazon or something. This hat is a Neff Brambini, and this is a Charisma brand wig off Amazon. You can check my FAQ in the description box if you need spelling. So yeah, without further ado, I don't want to blabber on any longer. Let's get into ranking these palettes. I would like to start by saying that there are a lot of winners in this one. Like, I truly don't dislike any of these palettes. So this ranking was fairly difficult in the sense that I really enjoy everything. So even the things that are in the bottom, I really don't consider to be bad at all. Let's kick it off with number 10, the only ColourPop palette. Sometimes these videos are full of ColourPop. This is the only one. This is the Orchid You Not palette. This is actually what I used for this look today. I used the whole new Orchid collection for my Instagram. I really like this. I only just used this like very recently, but I love this. I think the colors are absolutely beautiful. It is so deep and rich, and I love that it's simply just mattes and shimmers, no pressed glitters, no sequin shadows. The shimmers are beautiful. I love this purpley duochrome on my lid. This is absolutely gorgeous, and I think it was very well timed with it being fall and then it's gonna be winter. I think this is beautiful. I can see myself actually reaching for this one a lot. I enjoy this one more than the Wine and Only. The Wine and Only is more burgundies. This is definitely more berry plum, and I love it. The main reason I didn't rank this one any higher is just because, I don't know, everything else coming up excites me just a wee bit more, but I do really enjoy this. I could have seen this one getting bumped up a bit more. Moving on to number 9, this is my Aether Beauty Moonlight palette. This is beautiful. I used this one in an Instagram video as well. I do want to use this in a get ready with me or something, but it just might be a while because I'm so, like, my schedule is crammed full filming for October, but I want to use this again soon, like actually on my channel. It's beautiful. These colors literally just look like moonlight reflecting on an enchanted pond. It's so pretty. The mattes are so blendable and soft, and the shimmers just look very just soft and wet looking. They're not crazy glitzy, but they just look very wet looking, and they have nice shifts to them as far as the duochromes go. I really enjoy Aether Beauty's formula. It's very buildable, very beginner friendly. I think this is gorgeous and a very fun color story. I think this is really romantic and just very enchanting. The main reason I didn't rank this one much higher is just because this isn't really the color story I'm gravitating towards too much this time of year. And there's gonna be some things in this video where you're like, then why did that get ranked so high? It's just because the formula was so superb. I do enjoy this a lot. There's just some other things that beat it out. Moving on to number 8. This is my Geology Cosmetics Pilbara palette. I love this. It's so cute. I'm so thankful they sent it to me because this has just been such a joy to play with. I actually featured this in my autumn favorites video, and I used this in, I want to say, a get ready with me and an Instagram video actually. Very fall harvest, very earthy, very pretty. The mattes again are very buildable and easy to use, and the shimmers are very glitzy and wet looking. I really enjoy them. I think the shimmers are more impactful than I expected. I didn't really expect much because this is their first palette they've ever come out with. I think it's their first product in general, actually. Not that I was expecting it to be bad, I just had no expectations, and this really astounded me. I think this is really pretty, and I'm actually really excited to see where they go from here. This color story is very up my alley this time of year. This one potentially could have gotten ranked a lot higher. It's just I love all the other palettes coming forward a little bit more than this one, but this is a really good contender. This one was a lot of fun, and I like how tiny and compact it is. Speaking of tiny and compact, ranked number 7 is going to be my Sugar Pill Fun Size 2 palette. This is one of those palettes where you're gonna be like, Betty Jean, if this isn't the color story you're vibing with this time of year, why did this get ranked so high? And my friend, It's because it just brings me so much joy. I don't know how to explain it. The first Sugar Pill Fun Size 2 is one of my favorites, and this one is such a good sequel. I did a first impressions, a two looks video, and an Instagram video. I played with this so much. It's so much fun. I love the tones in here. It's kind of grungy jewel tone, but there's also some weird kind of off-tone pastels. Like, it's not those true basic colors. It's kind of like shifted a little bit. I think this is a lot of fun to use. All mattes, very easy to blend. I've had such a good time with this and I loved the looks I created. And rounding out my bottom five of my last 10 palettes, I'm gonna give number 6 to my Alien Cosmetics Hauntingly Glamorous palette. They just sent this to me and I used it in a first impressions and it's so pretty. We have 9 mattes, a matte with like sparkle pressed into it and 2 duochrome-y toppery shimmers. This is so much fun. I love how rich and dark these mattes are. It's very, very enchanting. I love it. It's very spooky, but it's also very colorful. I think the choice of the shimmers were really pretty. I wish there might have been like 1 or 2 more shimmers because these shimmers are beautiful and I could have been more excited to see more of them. And I don't love mattes with sparkle pressed into it. It's just not my preference. So I would have preferred this green to be either a matte or a shimmer. But for the most part, I'm really enjoying this palette. I'm gonna be filming an Instagram video with it very soon. I think this is so lovely and I'm so happy for Sydney Nicole Adams, who is the collaborator of this palette. She did such a beautiful job with it and I'm pumped. I think the shade names are so cute. The main reason this one didn't get ranked any higher is just because I love the next 5 with my whole heart, but I do love this one more than the ones we just talked about, so it just kind of got to sit here in the middle. This one's a lot of fun, very appropriate for this time of year. I'm loving a spooky theme and I'm happy that more brands are jumping on Halloween themed palettes because there's been many years where nobody does anything for Halloween and it's a bummer. Moving on to my top 5. Again, I love these next 5 so much. You've already heard me talk about these, some of them multiple times. Let's get into it. Ranked number 5 is gonna be my Odin's Eye Red Dragon palette. This is in collaboration with Judy and I'm, again, just so proud of her. So many collabs in this video. This is really exciting. This is beautiful. I've already done a combination first impressions video where I used all 3 palettes from the Legendary Diversa collection. I did a 3 looks, 3 palettes video where I did like 1 look per palette, and then I did feature this one in its own Instagram video. I love it. It's gorgeous. Autumnal feels. I love these rich reds, this grungy chartreusey shade, and these shimmers are gorgeous. Odin's Eye has one of my favorite shimmer formulas ever. I'm so happy with this palette. It makes me so excited. I'm just so excited for that whole collection. The collaborators, it's amazing. So I knew this one was gonna get ranked up high. Again, the only reason this one didn't get ranked any higher than 5 is just because I love the next 4 color stories more than this one, but this one is absolutely gorgeous and so fitting for this time of year. Ranked number 4, we're giving it to the next Odin's Eye palette. This is in collaboration with the Fancy Face. This is the Hummingbird palette. This is so beautiful. Again, it's part of that combined first impressions video, combined 3 looks video, and I did its own individual Instagram video. This is just beautiful. It's very bright and colorful without it being a traditional rainbow. Again, these shimmers are outstanding. I did a really cool spooky Halloween-y look in my Instagram video where I played with the orange and purple together. Oh, it was so pretty and reflective. I loved it so much. And the mattes make me really happy. I like how there's really, really deep tones in here, but there's also this light blue to help buff things out. I think she did a great job with this palette. It's very unique. The shade Fancy, so cool. I'm very impressed with this. Moving on to my top 3. I love doing these videos, they make me so happy. Number 3 is going to be my Nomad Cosmetics Haunted Europe palette. I already did a 2 looks video as like a first impression style video and I have an Instagram video coming which may already be up by the time this video goes up. It's so spooky and beautiful. I love, again, the haunted theme. And to me, I'm able to break this palette in half in my brain where it's like this little half is a harvest pumpkin patch and this half is a spooky graveyard. And I love it. It creates such cool looks. I love the mattes. Nomad's matte formula is so lovely to work with. It is so easy to build up and blend out without it getting too carried away. I find it to be very beginner friendly. And the mattes are very glitzy, wet looking. They're not crazy like high pigment metallic per se, but they're just very glitzy, wet, sparkly. I love them. I think the choices of colors in here are really pretty because it's spooky without it just being a traditional Halloween palette. This makes me so happy. I love this palette so much. Ranked number 2, you already knew this was gonna get ranked high up. This is my Odin's Eye palette in collaboration with my friend Annette from Annette's Makeup Corner, who I also stole this video idea from, thank you very much. This is the Giant Wolves palette. This color story speaks to me on another level. Easily one of my favorite palettes I've tried so far this year. It's so gorgeous. I love the grungy, deep jewel tone mattes, and these shimmers are absolutely stunning. So many shifty shades. I love how just sparkly they are, and everything plays together so nicely and so uniquely. This is such a fun, beautiful palette, and I'm so excited for Annette. I knew this one was gonna make it up high. I had a feeling it was for sure gonna be one or two, and I'm so pleased to see it here. I have a strong feeling this is gonna be in my top 5, or at least top 10 for the year. And finally, number 1. This one already has my heart locked and sealed. I do technically still have to play with this one a little bit more, so if I end up finding out I don't like something about it later, I might have to knock it down a peg in my yearly one, but for now, I'm already so blown away. This is my Blend Bunny Cosmetics Surge palette. I am obsessed with this. I've only played with it once so far, but I'm already so over the moon, and I use so many shades in that look. I packed in so many things. I use things from all the different rows, all the different tones. I have had so much fun with this. I'm taking it on vacation with me in a week, which I think I should be either on that trip or freshly back by the time this video goes up. I don't even know when this video is going up. Everything is pre-filmed right now. It is pre-filming for Halloween in this household. But this is so fun. I'm so happy I treated myself to this. I'm not a big palette person, but when a big palette is done right and it's made creatively and it's unique, I'm all about it. This is so aesthetically pleasing. I love that we have the row of dusty pastels, not even rainbow pastels, but dusty, grungy pastels. And then we have the grungy, rich shades, and then the really dark, vampy, grungy shades. Oh my goodness, the beautiful jewel tone shimmers and then the bright neons at the bottom. This is so exciting and innovative. I love it. I found these mattes to blend like an absolute dream, which is what I was expecting, because everyone has been hyping up Blend Bunny Cosmetics first palette for such a long time now. I had some high expectations for this, and so far I am so beyond pleased, and this color story just wins my soul right now. I'm having so much fun with this. I can't wait to play with it more. Again, I already have a first impressions video up with this, but I will have a two looks video coming as soon as I can. It's gonna have to be after my trip, and I'm gonna have an Instagram video coming. I'm so excited. This is a good stack of palettes. So yeah, I would love to hear your thoughts. Did my ranking surprise you? I feel like it might surprise some of you, because it honestly surprised me a little bit with how I organized some of these things, but I had to just pour my heart and soul into this ranking because it was hard to rank some of them. I would love to know if you've tried any of these palettes or if you have your eye on them. Let me know all of your thoughts down below. If you made it to the end of this video, leave me your last 10 most recently used emojis. And if you like this video, you can give it a thumbs up. That helps my channel out a lot. And if you're not already, you can follow me on my other socials. You can join the Batty Bean fam. I am Batty Bean on everything. I post every day on Instagram, and I'm fairly active on TikTok and Twitter as well. And you can also subscribe if you want to see more of my videos. I'm uploading every single day in the month of October. Thank you so much for watching, and I will catch you in the next one. Okay, bye.